Windows 10 comes pretty bloated out of the box, but a few quick changes can make a huge difference in performance and usability. Howdy howdy guys, Ponchato here, and today I'm going to show you the first things I do on any PC I build for the best performance and to stop problems before they become problems. Before we get to that though, big thanks to SCDKey for sponsoring this video. SCDKey is a software and games key marketplace, and if you're looking for a Windows 10 key and want to spend way less than retail, SCDKey has you covered. They have Windows 10 Pro for only $14.84, and by using my discount code SKPON10% at checkout, you can get an extra 10% off your order. To get a Windows 10 key, click Buy Now. You'll need to sign into your account or make one, put in my code SKPON10%, then click Submit Order to check out. To get the key, go to your purchased orders, click View Keys/Codes, then Get the Key to show it. To activate Windows, open your Settings menu, Update and Security, Activation, then click Change Product Key. Enter your key in this window, click Next, then Activate to apply it. They also have Microsoft Office 2016 for $37 or Office 2019 for only $62 if you need the latest version. Beyond that, SCDKey also sells game keys for Steam, EA Origin, and Ubisoft's Uplay. Follow the links in the description to SCDKey and don't forget to use my discount code at checkout to get an extra 10% off your order. When it comes to PC builds, the first thing I always do after installing Windows is installing graphics and motherboard drivers. AMD and Nvidia both make it easy to get the latest version from their websites, and I prefer doing it this way to ensure you aren't running an old version of the drivers. It's also important to make sure the drivers are installed, because otherwise Windows 10 will just use Microsoft's built-in generic display driver. That offers only very basic functionality, pretty much just enough for the computer to function until you install the correct drivers from the actual GPU manufacturer. At this point, I also install the drivers for the motherboard components like audio and Ethernet. In my experience, most of the generic drivers built into Windows 10 work fine for most motherboard components, but not always. I have had issues come up that could only be fixed by installing the manufacturer's drivers, so for the sake of preventing problems before they start, and because I absolutely despise troubleshooting, I always install the motherboard drivers right away. These days, most motherboard manufacturers, thankfully, have decent websites that allow you to easily find your model and all the drivers for it. Spending a couple minutes to do that now can save hours of frustration later. Still on the subject of drivers, the second thing I do is prevent Windows Update from updating drivers. The main reason for this is simply that Microsoft doesn't always have the latest versions and may mistakenly remove more up-to-date drivers or install the wrong versions. It's best to just do it yourself so you know it's done correctly. It's a different procedure for Windows 10 Home and Pro, so we'll look at Home first. You'll need to open the registry editor by opening the Start menu, typing regedit, and hitting Enter. This is a simple fix, but it's a good idea to make a backup of your registry just in case by clicking File, Export, changing the export range to All, and then saving it where you can find it. After that, in the left pane, navigate to HKEY Local Machine, Software, Policies, Microsoft, Windows, and finally Windows Update. Now in the right pane, right-click and select New DWORD 32-bit Value. Make the value's name Exclude WU Drivers in Quality Update with no spaces, set its value to 1, and click OK. Once it's there, you can close the registry editor. On Windows 10 Pro, you can do this with the Group Policy Editor, which is basically just a front end for the registry and a bit easier to use. To open it, bring up your Start menu, type GP Edit, then hit Enter. The Group Policy Editor window will pop up, and this is where you have access to basically everything that the registry can do, but nicely organized and with descriptions of what all the options do. In the left pane, navigate to Computer Configuration, Administrative Templates, Windows Components, and Windows Update. Once you're here, find the setting called Do Not Include Drivers with Windows Update. It's a bit easier to find if you sort the settings alphabetically first, and double-click to open it. On this window, hit the radio button next to Enabled and click Apply. Now, as the name of the setting implies, Windows Update won't mess up all the drivers you installed correctly. You do need to restart your computer for the setting to take effect, but we have a few more settings that require a restart, so we'll hold off for now. The next thing I change is mouse acceleration. Now, before anyone blows up at me in the comments, yes, this is a personal preference, but most people who game on PC will agree that mouse acceleration is detrimental to your performance. I've been disabling mouse acceleration for so long now that it's actually kind of hard for me to use computers or mice with acceleration turned on because the movement doesn't make any sense. If you haven't heard of mouse acceleration, usually just called acceleration for short, it's a function built into Windows and even built into the hardware of some mice, particularly on the lower end, that increases your mouse's sensitivity proportional to how quickly you move it. It might help to put some example numbers on it. If you have mouse acceleration on and you move your mouse 5 inches to the right slowly, let's say your mouse cursor moved 500 pixels. But if you move your mouse 5 inches to the right quickly, your cursor might move 800 pixels. Compare that with acceleration off, where no matter how quickly or slowly you move your mouse, 5 inches of mouse movement will correspond to 500 pixels of cursor movement every single time. The main impact impact of acceleration is it reduces the repeatability of movements. With acceleration, your aim in games is based not only on how far you move your mouse, but also how fast. Disable acceleration and you remove that second variable, which, theoretically, will allow you to perform better in games and reach a higher skill ceiling. Okay, theory done, how do we turn it off? Open your start menu, type mouse, and hit enter to open your mouse settings. On this window, click additional mouse options to bring up your mouse properties. Switch to the pointer options tab and uncheck enhance pointer precision. Yes, this is labeled literally exactly opposite of what it actually does. If enhance pointer precision is checked, Windows adds acceleration to your mouse movements, which reduces pointer precision. It's stupid, I know. Anyway, click apply and you'll immediately notice your mouse movement feels very different. It can take a little while to get used to and your aim is going to be worse until you adjust to it, but you'll quickly be able to perform better in games as you retrain with a more accurate mouse movement setup. The next thing I do is change which update channel the computer uses. There are two channels, with one generally targeted toward individual users and the other for large organizations. I always switch to the one for organizations because updates there are tested more rigorously before being deployed. Going with the standard update channel has caused many problems for many people because issues with certain updates don't get discovered until they've already been dumped on thousands of computers. One of the worst was in the October 2018 Windows 10 update, where some people actually had their documents folder deleted because of a lazy programming mistake on Microsoft's side. Nice. Fortunately, it's pretty easy to switch. To switch your computer's update track, open the Start menu and start typing Windows Update until Windows Update Settings appears, then open it. Once the Update Settings window shows up, click Advanced Options and on this screen, click Semi-Annual Channel Targeted and switch it to Semi-Annual Channel. There's no OK or Apply button because it automatically saves your settings here. Now you won't be an unwitting beta tester anymore and get your documents folder deleted. The next thing I do is disable telemetry. There is an enormous privacy argument to be made here, but you don't even have to go down that path to want telemetry turned off. It affects performance. Sometimes, a lot. On lower end systems, issues with telemetry, or maybe just its normal functioning, it's impossible to tell, can make a computer almost unusable or kill gaming performance. The two most common issues are 100% CPU or 100% hard drive or SSD usage caused directly by telemetry, both of which I've experienced more than once. It is an absolutely infuriating problem to deal with, and it took me a while to find a tool that actually worked to stop it. The tool I use is called, appropriately, ShutUp10. It's a small download and I'll add a link in the description. When you run it, you're greeted with a simple interface with toggle switches for a host of options, most of them related to privacy. Feel free to enable all the recommended options, I usually do, but the ones we're interested in are in the security section. It'll ask if you want to create a system restore point before you change any settings, so choose either yes or no, then turn on the settings telemetry disabled 1 of 3, 2 of 3, and 3 of 3. Yes, there are three different layers that need to be peeled back to shut it off. You can then close ShutUp10 and it'll first confirm that you want to close it, then it'll remind you that you need to restart for the changes to take effect. Go ahead and restart, but your work isn't done yet because Microsoft is very persistent when it comes to telemetry. You'll probably need to run ShutUp10 again and disable this third telemetry option again for it to actually stick, and even then, Windows will still flip it back on from time to time. I usually run ShutUp10 once every few weeks to make sure telemetry is still completely disabled. But anyway, with it off, you're a lot less likely to run into CPU or storage lockups due to telemetry. The last thing I do on any Windows installation is remove all the garbage app that Microsoft includes by default. I'm not a Microsoft employee, so I can't say for certain, but I assume that Microsoft gets paid for each installation of Candy Crush, Farmville, and Minecraft that shows up on someone's computer, or they just get paid to do it up front. Doesn't matter. The point is, Microsoft puts junk on your computer, and you gotta get rid of it. I find the fastest way to do this is by opening the Start menu, typing Apps, and opening Apps and Features once it appears. Then on the window, starting at the top, remove every app you don't need, making sure not to remove any of the drivers you installed previously. Some built-in apps can't be removed, but most of the actual shovelware, like Candy Crush, can be removed from here. Once you've gone through that list, your start menu will probably look pretty rough, so you may want to clean it up a bit at this point. So those are the first things I do on any PC I build, and that leaves you with a much cleaner Windows installation, along with a much lower likelihood of encountering problems. And thanks again to SCD Key for sponsoring this video, and if you're looking for a very inexpensive Windows key, be sure to check them out by following the links in the description below. Hit subscribe and click the bell icon to get notified of new videos as soon as they're up. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit subscribe, and I want to hear from you. Mouse acceleration. Do you use it? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. I hope I helped, and I'll see you in the next video.
Let's do it.
Wouldn't it be nice if Microsoft actually cared about the user experience? I remember when they did, kind of.
Did they?
I don't know. What matters is, Windows XP was the best, and we're never gonna get it back. Rest in peace. It's getting hot in here. Microsoft is very, very persistent when it comes to telemetry, and it ruins performance. Why? Why do they do that?